Cyberpunk 2077 is a broken mess. However, underneath that mess of bugs, glitches, technical issues that completely break the experience for a lot of players, is an amazing game. So much so, that if the technical flaws weren't so intrusive and detrimental to the overall experience, I would even go as far as to say that it's one of the best games to come out in 2020. You're probably wondering to yourself, if this game is so great, then why did it fail? Why is it so broken? Why is everyone so mad? And the simple answer to that is, despite being a great game, it's not a good product. Not even close. Honestly, I could go all day talking about this game's problems. But in my opinion, there's more than enough people doing just that on YouTube, dissecting every problem, every glitch, technical flaw, every graphical imperfection. So instead, I'm gonna talk about something a bit more constructive. That's not to say that the YouTubers who are criticizing the game are wrong. In fact, they have every right to do so, considering the state it released in versus the state of the game that was promised. But to be honest with you, I would much rather talk about things that can improve a game rather than what's wrong with it. So here is a list of top 10 things CD Projekt Red could do to make Cyberpunk 2077 a better game. Number 1. Get rid of the loot system. If you're not fighting the game's glitches, you're fighting the game's menu. One thing it desperately needs is to be more neatly organized. One way of doing that is to get rid of the loot system. The loot system is useless. It's a bunch of guns, they're all the same, just with different stats. Instead of implementing a loot system where you get to pick up the same smart shotgun or tech pistol for 1,000 times, why not just give the player one weapon? One smart shotgun, one power shotgun, one smart pistol, one tech pistol, one katana. You get the idea. And instead, you get to upgrade it. Not only would switching a loot system with an old school upgrade system make life much easier, it would also give the gunshop owners a little bit more involvement, allowing you not only to purchase mods, silencers, and scopes, but to also offer a deeper and more meaningful level of customization. I honestly do not understand why CD Projekt Red did not market this game as a first-person shooter, because the shooting mechanics in this game are literally the best thing about it. It is not as polished as an experience like Doom or Rage 2, but the guns are really fun to play around with. For the most part, the weapons aren't anything new or groundbreaking, but they do borrow an idea or two from other great video games to keep it fresh and exciting. Long story short, the looting system is holding back the game's best feature from realizing its full potential. Get rid of it. Number 2. Remove stats from clothing and accessories. Even though you spend most of the game in first person, you do spend a lot of time looking at the menus, and honestly, it is quite odd looking at V wearing silly outfits just to increase the stats. The stat values attached to these clothes feel arbitrary. It feels as if there's no real thought put behind the stats of the clothes. You could be walking around in a bulky and badass leather jacket one minute, and then you'll be walking around with a thinner jacket the next, and that thinner jacket would have a much higher stat level than the bulky jacket, which makes no sense. In fact, the entire concept makes no sense. Why not stick the stats to the body instead of the clothes? Not only would this simple change make the game more fun and accessible, but it also makes the Ripper docks more important in the grand scheme of things. With this one single change, you'd be hitting two birds with one stone. Not only are you more incentivized to visit Ripper docks for upgrades, but you're also more incentivized to visit clothing shops. And on top of that, this could also help with the immersion, allowing you to believe that V is moving up in the world of Night City. I don't know about you, but in my opinion, it kinda helps along with the credibility. If you're gonna move up in the world of Night City, you might as well look good while doing so. Number 3. More believable crowds and dialogue interactions. While you cannot deny that the stylistic choices and art direction of Night City do their absolute best to make this feel like a living, breathing place, the crowd systems in this game completely destroy that illusion. In reality, these pedestrians and citizens are just generic NPCs that we've seen a million times before. They don't have anywhere to go, they stay in one place, they cross the roads, sometimes they don't cross the roads, they wait for an eternity. When you initiate a conversation with these people, you get absolutely nothing out of this. It's just the usual hello, or get out of my way, or leave me alone. Pretty much everything you've heard in every other open world game. Quite the opposite of what you'd call a believable crowd system, it brings nothing new to the table. It's just baffling. The developers created one of the most wonderfully detailed cities I've ever seen in a video game. And yet with this crowd system, It just feels so lifeless. Raccoon City feels more alive than this. Silent Hill feels more alive than this. The post-apocalyptic world of Death Stranding felt more alive than this. These are all worlds completely abandoned by society and normalcy, and yet they still feel more alive than Night City. This is because even with an uninhabited world, you can make it feel alive by pulling off the atmosphere and making that work. Night City, with the crowd functioning the way it does, it breaks the immersion and it ruins the atmosphere. I hope in a future patch, CD Projekt Red can fix this and finally deliver the crowd systems it was promising to the consumers. Number 4. Get rid of the wanted system. The wanted system in Cyberpunk 2077 is absolutely embarrassing. If you break the law in Night City, the police don't come chasing you. They just spawn next to you or behind you. What's even worse is if you drive away from them, they don't chase you because, get this, they don't drive. Whenever I get them to spawn, I just drive away for a few seconds and they despawn, even on 3 stars. That's pretty much it. They should just get rid of it completely. It's useless and V is doing jobs for the police anyway. All the footage you've been seeing so far is of V going around the city, taking down organized crime groups and collecting the bounties. Wouldn't it have been more believable if in a corrupt place like Night City, the police would turn a blind eye when you work for them? And it's not just that, this could also open more opportunities where you could get more quests from the police officers, where you have to actually make a choice whether to follow the justice system or to act as a vigilante who plays dirty and by his or her own rules. This would have made for a much more compelling dynamic than just earning street cred, and it also would have made the game much more of a role-playing game than it actually is. Number 5. Better character creation. While Cyberpunk's character creation tool isn't bad, the character creation tools leave a lot to be desired, and to be quite honest, the hype surrounding this feature definitely wasn't worth it. The character customization tools only allow you to select from presets instead of giving you a slider. A slider would have made things a lot more interesting. I'm not saying you should be able to create hideous characters or abominations like you could do in, say, Dark Souls, but it would have been nice if you got a little slider that can fine-tune the little details, such as bone structure and jaw size. I know this is a petty complaint, but yes, a slider would have made a world of a difference for the character creation tool. Aside from that, I also think the creation tool should get rid of the tattoo options, because the next one is going to be just about that. Number 6. Open up tattoo shops around Night City. There are a lot of things that break the immersion in Night City, and yet you can't help but feel that within this world, there is a sense of appreciation to art and the artistic expression. From the colors of the city, the pavements, the streets, the way the people wear clothes, the way the buildings and architecture look, and how uniform everything is. To me, it just begs the question, why is there no tattoo shops in this city? A place such as this that thrives in artistic expression and color vibrancy, basking in the endless beauty of saturated colors and neon lights. A tattoo shop would only add more to that sense of immersion. If this were to somehow be implemented into the game via a patch or something down the line, in addition to a wider variety and selection of tattoos, I think that this would elevate the experience even more. Number 7. Crafting. The crafting system in Cyberpunk lacks feedback. I can't even tell you how many times I was crafting something, and because there was no sound at the end of the crafting function, I would not have known or guessed that I've actually crafted the thing. I'd have to go back into the menu and check to confirm that it's been crafted. Again, this is a very small complaint, but then again, that's why it's on the list. Something this small and basic is probably far easier to achieve with a patch, and given how frustrating this thing is, despite being one of the tiniest inconveniences, I don't see why this should not be fixed. Number 8. Hairstyle customization. Despite being able to see your character on screen in the menus and in the character creation tool, you don't really get to change the hairstyle after that. The character creation tool is the first and last time that you get this option. When you play as Geralt in The Witcher 3, it was really fun to be able to change around your hair or beard style. So it's pretty weird how it somehow did not make it into this game. Especially considering you do have mirrors you can look at for whatever reason, even though half the time it doesn't work. Maybe this feature was intended to be in the game, but they had to cut it out. That's just what I think, so don't quote me on that. But yet again, like many of the other things on this list, it just feels like yet another missed opportunity. And I think CD Projekt Red could really do with a feature like that if they decide to add it back for Cyberpunk. Number 9. Selling weapons in bulk. When you go to a drop point, you are able to sell junk in bulk, however, you are not able to sell anything else in bulk, which is frustrating considering the amount of times you have to go back and forth trying to sell the firearms just so you can make some money in this game. Lacking the ability to sell in bulk hurts this game as much as the loot system does, in the same sense that it's causing you to spend more time in the menus organizing your stuff rather than actually playing the game. I do not understand the obsession of wanting to pad out a game, make it longer, more bloated, if it doesn't have to be. I would much rather a game be more short, concise, and to the point than actually being a bloated mess. It seems as if everything in this game was made in such a way to go out of its way to hurt the pacing and game length that you would spend on a game, whereas if it was a neater, more concentrated package, it would have been a much more smoother and a much more enjoyable experience. Speaking of a much more enjoyable experience, number 10, a stable frame rate. As of this moment while recording this video, I'm running it on the patch 1.05 on the PS4 Pro. The game runs decent enough. It crashes a few times here and there. The frame rate is a bit better, but not by much. This is still way below 30 frames per second, especially during intense battles, shootouts, and especially when driving through some of the more urban areas, the one with the taller buildings and skyscrapers. That part really hurts the frame rate. I really hope that out of all of these fixes, a stable frame rate is the one that's prioritized the most. So anyway, those have been the top 10 things that would make Cyberpunk better, in my humble opinion, of course. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like. If you disliked the video, leave a dislike. If you agree or disagree with anything I've said in this video, be sure to leave a comment down below. I would love to hear your feedback, whether positive or negative. As of right now, I am not sure if I'm gonna continue making Cyberpunk videos. I just thought it would be a cool video to start with. If you enjoy the content, be sure to leave a subscribe and do not forget to ring the notification bell. That way you will know when I post my next video. If you made it all the way to the end of this video, I wish to thank you for watching. And even if you didn't, thank you so much for giving this video a chance and I wish you all a happy new year. This was Dion from Ravendraws. On this channel, I will be doing reviews, discussions, and also drawings of video games and movies I like to talk about. Once again, thank you guys for watching and I'll see you next time.